Hello there, welcome to my channel. I am Bryan Lomax and this is my review of The Hitcher 2. I've been waiting. As with the first film, in case you didn't know, yes, I have reviewed that already, but I did that in collaboration with Cody Leach. So over on his channel, he also reviewed The Hitcher. Same again. Cody Leach should be reviewing The Hitcher 2. We'll be releasing these around about the same time. Go over, check his review of the film out as well. The Hitcher 2 was released in 2003. It is directed by Luis Murnau. I think that's how you pronounce his name. Stars C. Thomas Howell once again, Carrie Wuerer, and the master of acting that is Jake Busey. So I didn't even know that this film existed until the remake came out. So the remake came out a few years after this, in 2007. Hitcher's one of my favourite films of the 80s. I thought doing a remake was a bad idea, to be honest. I thought, if you're going to do anything, do a sequel. And then I found out, they have. And everything I heard about it and what I knew of it, you know, it's one of those straight-to-DVD kind of affairs. It just did not interest me. Having reviewed the first film, I thought, yeah, it's time. It's time to bite that bullet, jump in, watch The Hitcher 2. I've been waiting. The sequel that nobody was waiting for. We pick up 20 years after the first film and we've got C. Thomas Howell's character, now a cop, but still suffering in a Laurie Strode kind of way, you know, Halloween 2018 kind of way, where it's just done so much damage to him that he just can't function properly in life. Everything he thinks about like reverts back to his time with the Hitcher. How this guy is still a cop, I don't know, because he's clearly suffering some psychological damage that would probably not enable him to do the job very well. Clearly, because he murders a guy right at the start of the film, he needs to deal with all this psychological crap that he's clearly not dealt with. He goes to see the sheriff from the first film, played here by a different actor, because Jeffrey DeMunn had sense not to come and tie his name to this film. And obviously, because he's making his way back to the old town, the Hitcher strikes again. Only this time he's played by Jake Busey. The story is feeble at best. I feel like they're trying to pepper in moments of the supernatural as to make you question, oh, is this the same guy? Or is it a reincarnation of the same guy? It's pretty well discussed in the original film. A lot of people have different takes on it, different readings. And one of those readings is that the Hitcher is some kind of demonic force, because we don't know much about him. They can't get anything from his fingerprints. And he seems to be unkillable for the most part. They never out and out say that, oh, he's definitely supernatural or anything. It's just, but then here, it's just like they don't really delve into it in any meaningful way. They just say, yeah, he's back. How is he back? Are we meant to believe that he just simply didn't die? In which case, why isn't that explained? Why don't we get like some kind of flashback saying as to why he survived? Has he just gotten out of the hospital? What? It's just absolutely nonsensical. He turns up and then the Hitcher just randomly arrives. Like the title says, I've been waiting. So we're supposed to believe that he's literally been waiting for 20 years. What, by the roadside? Aside from the fact that Jake Busey is much younger than what the Rutger Hauer version of the character would have been at the time, it's just, all of these things are questions that you shouldn't be asking yourself while you're watching the film, because all it does is stop you from paying attention to the film, because you're too busy asking these questions that the film never bothers to attempt to answer. Next to that, you've got, spoiler alert, C. Thomas Howell, obviously the main character from the first film. He's back here. That is actually a pretty good, pretty good snare when you're able to get the original actor back from the original film. So what do? You waste him within the first third. He's gone. They kill him. Done. Dusted. Boom. Out. It becomes Carrie Wuerer's story. And she's got no charisma. I don't care for her character because they don't give us a reason to, other than the fact that she's the girlfriend, the wife of the C. Thomas Howell character, zero character development. Like I say, they start off trying to do something with Howell's character because of the trauma that he's suffered, and but no, he's actually not our main character in this. They waste him within the first third, so then whatever character depth is there has just gone. And it's literally about Jake Busey's Hitcher tormenting Wara. Some of that, I will grant you, in a made-for-TV, not an actual sequel to an original classic kind of way, is quite entertaining. It just holds no weight. It's completely forgettable. Like, I literally can't remember anything. I remember a truck blowing up, and I remember her trapped inside a big empty water tank. Beyond that, no. I've got nothing. The score for this film is awful. It sounds like stock music. It's that kind of piano music, and it plays constantly. No matter what the scene, no matter where you are in the film, there is music playing all the time. So it's composed by Joe Kramer, and the only things he's done of note are his work with Chris McQuarrie. I don't know how he landed that gig, to be honest. They must be personal friends. But yeah, he did the music to Way of the Gun, Jack Reacher, one of the Mission Impossible films. That's the only thing he's done of note to me. You know, I look at his CV on Letterboxd, I'm like, it's just a never-ending series of straight-to-DVD or made-for-TV movies with that plinkety-plunkety piano music that plays throughout non-stop without any break whatsoever. The dialogue in this film is terrible, as you would expect. Jake Busey does nothing to heighten it. You know, there are certain actors that can take something that isn't that great and they can at least do something with it, but it's just... I feel like he's lost in this film. He's got no charisma at all. When you stack him up next to Rutger Hauer, I think the film flat out seems to want us to believe that this is the same guy. I don't believe it, not for a second. He doesn't have the charisma. He doesn't have that kind of death wish vibe about him. That lost soul feel that Rutger Hauer kind of had. It seems like schoolboy antics. I think there was room here to have had a decent sequel. You take the C. Thomas Howell character and you make him a cop because of what he went through, and then you get some kind of copycat killer that is doing something very similar to what happened with him, and then he has to become embroiled in that as a result. If you have to go down that route, fine, whatever, but just call it out. Say it's a copycat killer. Don't try to make out that it's the same dude, even though it's clearly not. And don't do all the crazy ass stuff you did with the main character from the first film that you do here that just destroys the legacy of that character. Terrible film. Some moderately competent action sequences aside, some entertaining death scenes aside, kudos to the fact that they were actually able to get Howell back. Although, you know, his career wasn't exactly... it wasn't doing much, was it? They probably didn't have to do that much to get him back, to be perfectly honest. It's a load of crap. I'm going to give this a 2 out of 5. I'm never going to watch it again. If this was just... If I had no knowledge of The Hitcher and I was up late one night, this came on TV, you know, I know it's a made-for-TV movie, whatever, and it comes on, I was like... That wasn't half bad for, you know, for a straight-to-DVD thing. It was a pretty interesting kind of story. But you're a sequel to one of the best movies of the 80s. As such, it must do better. So there you go. There's my thoughts on The Hitcher 2. I've been waiting. Do check out Cody Leach's review of this movie as well. Do also, please, if you don't mind, clicking that thumbs up button down there. Hit subscribe if you haven't done so already. And also do check out my membership program and the Patreon page so you can see what wonderful perks you get when you become a supporter of this channel. Thank you for watching this video, and until next time, cracking.